So we have to remember, we have to continue this fight for Calvin Horton, who was wrongfully killed by the owner of Cadillac Jewelry and Pawn, which is now owned by, as we're told, another individual. It's now Pawn Jewelry. But this is where the owner shot out of his store into the street of protesters, fatally wounding Calvin Horton.
There are protesters in this crowd right now that have spent more time in jail than John Rieple did for shooting and killing a man. If this does not spell out to you what this city council, what these elected officials, and who these leaders are about, I don't know what does. Calvin L. Horton Jr. deserves justice. This family deserves more than justice. They deserve to be heard.
I'm so proud to stand with this family. And I'm so proud that you are out here to stand with this family. We cannot tolerate this kind of injustice. And most people know the people that are out here. We know each other from doing work around police accountability. But what we also know is another form of police, a lack of police accountability, is when the police fail to provide justice for families. And we know that there's a huge issue with the Minneapolis Homicide Department, because they fail time and time and time again to meaningfully investigate and lead to the prosecution of the people who kill people of color. We know this. This is a huge issue. I'm working with at least a dozen families who never got justice for their loved one that was killed in street violence because the Minneapolis police failed to meaningfully investigate these cases.
And so ultimately, y'all, you know where I'm going with this. I gotta say it. Ultimately, if this thing ain't working, we gotta change it. Right? If it's not working, we gotta change it. That's what it comes down to. If it's not working, we have to make up our minds we're gonna transform this thing. Because it's not working. We keep coming out here, coming out here, coming out here, coming. At some point, the lights gotta go on. That these people are lying to us when they're telling us how wonderful they are, what a just system we live under, right?
Thank you, all of you that keep on being out here that I've seen for too long. I want to see you guys in a different space. You know what I'm saying? But I appreciate you, because a lot of our rights we only have because y'all show up. And people don't always see that. But I've gotten to see with Brother Mel even sometimes where somebody goes in, gets taken in, and we say, let them out. And it might take a couple hours, but you know what? We're gonna do it together. Amen. You know what I'm saying? And I've seen that happen. And a lot of people don't recognize how many of their rights they have because y'all stay outside with your boots. Boots! Boots on the ground!
While protesting, rightfully so, Calvin was murdered. And this was the beginning of the Black Lives Matter versus Blue Lives Matter debate, right? We had people, business owners, white folks that were just mad about what was going on, saying they support the police coming into the city and trying to do the police's job for them. Right, how can you back the blue and say you support the police, but then come into a city with your guns ready to protect property because you don't think the police is doing a good enough job? In Minnesota, you cannot protect your property with your gun when you can retreat. You cannot take life to protect your property, but he did it anyway.
I want to say happy birthday, Dad, first and foremost. We are still, of course, fighting to get justice for him. This has been really, really hard on our family. The dude spent two nights in jail for a murder. Like, that's ridiculous.
When I read in that police report, he never should have even got out of jail. So therefore, they just don't know. This mother is not going down and let her son's death go in vain. Calvin, my son, I love him. And may he rest in peace. But we will get justice.
Happy birthday, Calvin! Happy heavenly birthday! Woo!
Messages of love for Calvin Horton.